Hello everyone, let's talk about multiboot. Multiboot is the technology which allows you to have multiple operating systems installed on a single computer at the same time. Now, some applications that we install might require the latest OS and the latest patches, while other applications might require a legacy or older operating system. By using multiboot, we can have all that on one machine. So to start out, one of the first things we need to discuss is having a second partition available. So I can go to my disk management area. And in my disk management area, you'll see that I have 80 gigs of unallocated space, perfect to install a second operating system on and have it running on my computer. Besides that, we can take a look at some of the settings that exist regarding multiboot. I can go ahead and click on my Windows icon for start, and I can click on Control Panel. Inside the Control Panel, I can click on System and Security. Within System and Security, I can click on System. When this window opens up, we need to go to our Advanced System Settings. I can click on that. In Advanced System Settings, we're going to go to the Settings options within the category of Startup and Recovery. Inside of here at this time, what we can view at the top is the default operating system is set to be Windows 10. That will be the Windows operating system that is chosen when our computer first boots. Below that, we can see a check mark for our time to display the list of operating systems installed on our computer, which is the default of 30 seconds. Also, if we're concerned about recovery options and them appearing, we can also do a check mark for that. What we're showing now is that I have only one operating system installed, and that's seen as the Windows 10 operating system. That's part of our boot manager file, which is able to give us these settings in this dropdown. So at this time, we're going to pause our recording, and I'm going to install a second operating system and that 80 gigs of free space inside of our disk management area. So I finished my install of Ubuntu within that 80 gigs of unallocated space. Now that the install is completed, my computer is rebooted, and we can see that I have my grub loader. The grub loader is going to be the Linux loader, so we can pick an operating system. At the top, I have Ubuntu, and at the bottom, I've got my Windows 10 install. Now this will come up every time I reboot my computer now, I have the chance to pick which OS I want to run on this single computer. When I have Windows 10 highlighted, I can go ahead and click Enter, and my Windows operating system is now going to start to boot. My Windows 10 operating system comes back online. I can log in using my credentials. With my system booted up successfully, I can right click on my Start Windows button and go to Disk Management. Let's check out that 80 gigs of unallocated space. It is unallocated no longer. It is now marked as a healthy partition, and that's seen as disk 0 partition 3. On top of that, if I open up a file explorer, I can check out the this PC area. And what we'll see inside of here, there is no second partition of disk 0 partition 3 because that's being used by the Linux Ubuntu operating system. We are done. We have a successful multi-boot environment on this computer, where each time I boot up, I get to choose Ubuntu or Windows 10. Thanks for watching.